Very interesting thing. And then you come from a very diversified background and thing.
Right.
So say everybody, there are say, I don't know, millions of book on leaderships, and there are millions of trainings which are around leadership. And how do we define leadership? Like, what is leadership in a nutshell? Like, what is your opinion about leadership?
Yes, that's a fantastic question, Sanket. In fact, one word answer for leadership is ownership. The moment we say ownership, we are taking ownership for the planning, for the execution, for the results, and not just that, for managing the entire stakeholder expectations, their aspirations. So it becomes a huge, huge responsibility. And it is also position agnostic, whether an individual is just a software engineer or an SVP, the behavior doesn't change. The scope will change. That is a fundamental difference. And based on a lot of studies, people say that emotional intelligence is the most important trait for a leader. And what I would say is, yes, it is most important, right? And you will be using only if I am feeling connected, if I am feeling that ownership, sense of ownership. So for me, unless until I say, okay, this is my baby, there is no leadership.
Okay, so the whole idea which I am picking up here is that the behavior which owns the actions as well as the results, not looking for passing the excuses or passing the reasoning something when something goes wrong, is a kind of an essential behavior you see in the leadership. So the way you define leadership is that buck stops there. So there is no, like, when things comes to that person, the person says, okay, I need to handle it, rather than saying, okay, I need to escalate to someone or transfer it to someone. So leadership is all about not looking back and finding someone else to take care of it. It's holding the thing then and there and says, okay, this is where you stop and I need to do something about it.
Correct. Best example I can give you.